Hey everybody, I'm Erin, and today I'm going to be doing another book tag. This one is the Reader Problems book tag. Once again, I've got my questions sitting over there, so I have my hands free to talk with. The first question for this one is, you have 20,000 books in your TBR. How did you know? How in the world do you decide what to read next? I don't actually have 20,000 books in my TBR. I think my TBR on Goodreads is like somewhere around 1,400 or 1,500 books, and at home it's probably closer to 100 to 150. But usually I go by what I feel like reading, and I tried doing book like TBRs and putting something together every month, going, you know, this month I will read this, and I always failed. So I realized that I'm just really a reader by feel. I will go in and, you know what, today I really feel like something light and fun, so I'm gonna read a cozy. Ooh, I haven't read some Ian Rankin for a while, so I'll read that, or whatever, you know? Maybe I feel like the science fiction. I've got a few of those I need to get to, too. So, yeah, that's how I do that. You're halfway through a book, and you're just not loving it. Do you put it down, or are you committed? It depends. Most of the time, I'm committed and I try to get through it. Sometimes I'll like continue reading it, like I'll force myself to read like three pages a night or a chapter a night, and then go on to read something else that I'm enjoying reading at the time, so that I still manage to finish that book that's not grabbing my attention, but I'm not putting myself in a slump trying to do it. The end of the year is coming. Yes, it is. And you're behind on your reading challenge. No, I'm not. Do you try to catch up? In the past I have, and it just stressed me out, so no. If so, how? I tried reading shorter books, I tried like spending way more time reading. I've learned to set my expectations a little lower now, and I tend to meet my goal much earlier. Then I don't have to worry about it at all, and then my reading's pleasurable, so it makes it more fun. The covers of a series you love do not match. How do you cope? I don't care. I actually just ordered, on Book Outlet, I ordered a bunch of the Miriam Black series by Chuck Wendig. And one's a hardcover and one's a softcover, and there's like a scratch and dent copy, and I'm like, I don't care. Everyone and their mother loves a book that you do not. Who do you bond with over your shared feelings? I tend to rant at people that like them. The worst way to do this. Like, someone likes it, I'm like, what do you mean? How do you like that? This is wrong with it, this is wrong with it, this is wrong with it, and you're an idiot. How to win friends and influence people. But if I don't do that, like if I actually find someone that feels the same way about it, I will comment on their Goodreads review, on their Twitter, wherever they do their review or talk about it, BookTube, and then I just kind of move on. I find that I'm better at ranting at people than actually commiserating with people. You're reading a book in public and you're about to start crying. How do you deal? Oh my God. I was reading, I think it was Christmas with Tucker or some book. It was about a dog. Go figure. And I was on the bus and I was like, all the way home, I'm just like, I'm just going, people aren't noticing, are they? They don't seem to be. I just cry, you know, whatever. Judge me. The sequel to a book you loved just came out, but you've forgotten a lot of what happens. Are you going to reread it? No. Nope. I will read the next book in the series and go, oh, right, I remember that. Or sit there and go, what? Who's this character? When did that happen? Yeah, I won't reread it. You do not want anyone to borrow your books. How do you politely say no when someone asks? I don't. A lot of my books are used, and I don't really have any attachment to my books. Yes, there are some that I don't, like I lent out The Color of Magic by Terry Pratchett, and my friend actually ripped a page in it, and she was like, I'm never borrowing a book from you again because now I have to replace it. So she did, she replaced it, and I felt really bad asking her to replace it, but I'm like, come on. It was brand new when I lent it to you because I bought it because the last time I lent it to someone, I didn't get it back and I don't know where it went. So, I don't say no, but I'm also aware that they might not come back, and that's just the way things go. You've picked up and put down 5 books in the last month. How do you get over this reading slump? Pick up something tried and true. So because I read a lot of series, I know that when I read Jessica Fletcher, what it's going to be like. I know if I read Ian Rankin, I know what I'm in for. So if I'm in a reading slump, I'm not going to pick up something I know is heavy. I'm going to go for something that I know what to expect. So I will pick up a cozy mystery or something like that and just be like, through it, and then all of a sudden I feel good again, and I enjoyed what I read, and I knew I'd enjoy it, and life is good. There are so many books coming out that you are dying to read. How many do you end up buying? I haven't been buying a lot of new books. I mean, I picked up there's a few books that I picked up this year that were new, but mostly I shop at secondhand stores and book outlet. So I'm not, I'm patient. And if not, I go to the library, or I'll buy like one, or I try to prioritize it and buy one or two. After you purchase all of these books that you're dying to read, how long do they sit on your shelves before you get to them? So this book right here, Terry Pratchett's Raising Steam, I purchased last year in a Boxing Day sale, so it was after Christmas, and I'm just getting around to reading it. That is not the oldest book currently sitting on my to-read pile on my shelves. In fact, this book I forgot I'd purchased. So I bought this at the Wee Book Inn in Edmonton. I have not shopped at a Wee Book Inn since I moved to Calgary from Edmonton. I moved to Calgary in 2011. So this has sat on my shelf for at least 6 years. I don't know how long before that. I found it in the garage this year and I went, oh, I didn't know I bought that. So yeah. It could sit on my shelf for years before I get around to reading it. And there's a whole lot of science fiction on my other shelves that, yeah, it's gonna sit there for a long time before I get around to reading it. Sometimes though, I read them immediately, but I've been buying a lot of books this year and I just bought, I think it was 20 books on Book Outlet sale. So those will be coming soon. Some of them I'm gonna get to right away, like the Chuck Wendig ones, but there's a good chance that some of those books I'm not gonna get to right away. That was the Reader Problems of Book Tag. I don't know if anyone has actually done this recently. I don't even know when it was created. I'm not gonna tag anyone, but let me, like, redo it if you feel like it, obviously. And let me know if you do, because I wanna watch it. I wanna know what everyone else's reader problems are. Yeah, so that's another tag from me. I will talk to you guys later. Let me know what you think if you have any feedback. So, bye.